today I'm gonna bring back one of the old videos that I used to do that everyone used to do way back when. I know some people still do them, so yeah, I don't know. I quite like filming them, watching them, and I thought you might too. So here I am doing a bit of my monthly favorites slash things that I'm loving at the moment. I don't know if it's gonna be a monthly thing or not, that depends on if you guys like it or not, so just let me know. But let's just go ahead and start with all this stuff. I'm gonna start with makeup just because that's how I used to do them, so I don't know. That's what I'm gonna do. The first thing here is the lipstick that I'm wearing right now. It's this one here. It's the only one matte range, and this is from Rimmel, and it's just this pink one in the number 200, which is called Salute. It's just this pink color. You can see it in my lips right now, but it just looks very pretty. It's like an overall daily pink. You can wear it for whatever, and I quite like that these lipsticks are quite straight up at the top, so they don't come up like that. They're just like slanted, but I quite like that because for some reason it makes it really easy to apply on my lips, whereas other lipsticks I do have a bit of a problem with. I don't know if it's the lipsticks or the shape of my lips, but I quite really like this range. I have three lipsticks from it. This is my most recent one and I'm loving it. You're gonna see a theme here, and I feel like it's been a theme sort of. It's like a mini theme, sub theme, in some of my videos where I'm starting to get back into pink things again. Pink lipstick, I'm wearing sort of a pinkish look on my eyes today from my Naked 3 palettes. And then I bought three nail polishes because I was getting bored of my nail polishes. I still love my black nail polish, that's like my ultimate thing that I love. I was getting bored of them, I just didn't really know what color to paint my nails, so I wasn't painting them that much, but I wanted them painted, so I went ahead, went to Boots, got some nail polishes, so I got three from Barry M. And here's a bit of that theme that I was talking about. This here are the three nail polishes that I got. I don't know where you can see them, I'll do a close-up. But basically, they're three somewhat pinkish shades. One of them is more like a pink nude, then there's like a light pink and a more actual pink, I don't know what. Don't know how to describe colors, but basically this one here, which is what I'm wearing right now, my nails, it's a bit chipped. Had it on for a week, but this is the Jelly High Shine Nail Paint from Barry M. All three of them are from the same Barry M range. This one is in the color Almond, then the light pink is in the color Pink Lemonade, and this one here is in the color Acai Smoothie. And I did a lot of research before I bought them. I went online and looked up pink Barry M nail polishes, and these were pretty much the three that everyone said they were amazing, so I went ahead and bought them. I think when I went, they were on a 3-4-2 makeup thing at Boots, like they do every once in a while, so that's why I got three of them, because one of them was basically free. Then I have a fashion favorite, which you saw me wearing in my previous video, and it's this sort of green jumper. I don't know if you can see the color, but it's like a dark green color. This is from Brandy Melville. I love Brandy Melville clothes because this top is from Brandy as well. I just love them because they're very soft, they're very comfortable to wear, they're just solid colors. Most of the time you do get some patterns and some graphic stuff, but the stuff that I buy the most is just like solid, very plain, very neutral, very you can wear with whatever you want. So that's one of the things that I love about that shop, that you can just buy things that you're gonna wear a lot, and that's why this is my new favorite. I feel like I've been trying to be a lot more colorful, and this is one of the things that's helped me because it's still quite dark, still my style, but it is a bit of color rather than just, you know, my grays, which is where I'm wearing today, another gray top, but you know, I'm trying. Now we're going into the random stuff. I'm gonna start with a few things that I got at Disneyland Paris. I'm gonna make a vlog on this. I have footage for the vlog, I just need to edit it, but I'm gonna post a vlog on it soon, hopefully. And I went to Disneyland Paris with my boyfriend a few weeks ago. It was my Christmas present, so from him, so really happy about that. And I bought a few things that I wanted to share with you because I love them. Two of them are pins. The first one is on my corkboard over there. I'm not gonna take it down, but I'll show you a clip of it here. And it's just a plain Disneyland Paris with a Mickey Mouse, because I do have, which I put next to it, a Disneyland California one that I bought, so I just wanted like a basic castle one, or like a basic Disneyland and the place where it's from one. And then I bought a different one, which is here. It's still in its packaging because I'm not gonna put it up on the board. I don't know what to do with my pins. I want to buy one of those like banner things that you put pins on, and I want to collect them, but I don't have that many right now, so I'm not sure what to do. So this is still in this packaging, but this is one of the attraction collection ones. I'm not sure how that all works. If you guys are into buying Disneyland pins, let me know. I know it's a thing, but this is a Buzz Lightyear one. So we went on the Buzz Lightyear ride. It's one of my favorites. And this is a pin that's sort of about that ride. They had loads, they didn't have that many pins compared to California. So I need to go back to LA just so I can buy some Disney pins, because they didn't have as much merchandise in general, which was a bit disappointing because I was ready to spend all my money there. But doesn't matter. I got this one, which is just a Buzz Lightyear. It says Buzz Lightyear Laser Blast, which is the name of the ride. And then it has like the Galactic Hero Status, which is what you get if you get to the top of the scoring thing in the ride. So it just has like that score on it, and yeah, like the Galactic Hero Status. I thought it was cool. I quite like Toy Story. I love Buzz Lightyear. I posted a picture with the Buzz Lightyear statue thingy at Disneyland on my Instagram. I'll put it here. If you don't follow me on Instagram, go and do that. But I just love it, so I bought that one. And the last one isn't a pin, but this is this key. And it's a keychain. I don't want it as a keychain, but that's what it is. So this thing here is a key from the Hollywood Tower Hotel, which is also known as the Tower of Terror ride. So basically, this is pretending to be a key for one of the hotel rooms in that hotel. That's my favorite ride out of all of the Disneyland parks that I've ever been to. I just love it. Very sad that it's now Guardians of the Galaxy in LA, but it's still Tower of Terror at Disneyland Paris. So of course I went on it, and of course I had to buy this. When I saw it, I don't know what I'm gonna do with it, but I had to buy it. So it's basically like a room key, and it has the HTH logo thing on there, and then a little thingy here that does say the Hollywood Tower Hotel, room 1313. Anyway, I thought it was very cool, and I had to buy it. Now on to more random favorites, TV shows. I'm gonna start talking about one of my favorites, which is Westworld. And you might have heard me talk about it before because I've already watched it. This was my second time watching the whole first series because my boyfriend hadn't seen it, and season 2 is coming out. So of course I had to get him into it, and he loved it, of course, who wouldn't? But just wanted to come back and tell you guys how amazing it is, because Westworld, if you've never heard about it, it's sort of like a futuristic theme park sort of thing, where people, like humans, go in and they live in this Western theme park, I guess, where everyone there is a robot except people that go there. And I don't know how to explain this show, but it's really good if you are into AI, futuristic things, dystopian, all that stuff. You're gonna love it. It's made by Jonathan Nolan and Lisa Joy, and they're really good. I love what they do. Yeah, it's a really good show. If you haven't seen it, go for it. It's amazing. Watch it before season 2, because then you're gonna get spoilers, and you do not want that. Then one of my all-time favorites came back, and that's Jane the Virgin. I'm still loving it. It's so funny. It's so well made. I love how they tie in with a lot of like pop culture stuff. I don't know, I feel like they're very self-aware. That's the word. That's what I'm talking about. It's a very self-aware show, and I just love that about it. Aside from all the funny, all the stuff that it is already, I just really like it. And if you haven't seen it, because it seems like a weird premise, it has a weird name, and you don't know what it's about, watch it, trust me. And the last one is one that I don't like saying that I love it, but I do, and it's America's Next Top Model. It's the only, aside from a few random Project Runway episodes that I watch here and there, it's the only reality TV show that I watch, because I do not like reality TV, and I hate that I love it, and I hate all the bits where they're just like bickering at each other in the house and stuff. I just don't like that part, but I do like the modeling side of it and all the pictures they take, and yeah, all that fashion side of it I love, all the reality TV side of it I do not. But I do like that show, it's back on. If you watch it, let me know who is your favorite, who do you want as the winner. I want Christiana as the winner. I feel like she's just amazing, and she seems to be one of the nicest people in the house, as well as the better model, so that's my favorite, that's who I want to see winning, but let's see what happens. The last thing, it's a book, it's called Thunderhead, and it's the second book to a series which starts with Scythe. These are by Neil Schusterman. I talked about Scythe a while ago. It's sort of futuristic and dystopian and a bit young adult. And it's a society where death doesn't really exist naturally anymore. So some people have to become scythes and they go and kill people every once in a while to compensate for overpopulation and stuff like that. So it's really good. Second part was amazing as well. Really excited for the third one to come out, but I will do a video on books soon. I just need to read a bit more because I haven't been that great at it this year. And that's gonna be everything for today. I really hope you guys liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And let me know if you want monthly ones or not, because I can do them or I cannot do them. Depends on what you guys want. So yeah, let me know in the comments and I will see you guys later with another video. Bye!